Hey, what's up, everybody? So today, I'm going to show you what I picked up at a local comic show that I went to. So I got a lot of books, so I think I did a pretty good job on kind of keeping focus on what I was looking for. Mostly it's one title. I did get some other stuff as well. So yeah, let's just jump right in. It was a good time, and you know, going through long boxes and short boxes just puts me at ease, and it was just a nice day to just kind of just rummage through so many books. You know, they were actually not too badly priced. I was thinking about picking up some Supergirls. I only found one. The rest of them were like $2 a piece, and they were like just, I don't know. They were just weren't appealing to pick up. So yeah. Let's jump right in here. We'll start with the odds and ends stuff. We got Superman Save the Planet, issue number one. I think this is a one-shot. And so I've never seen this before. I think it was like $3, and I was like, why not just pick it up? It's by Luis Simonson. So got that. This is my only Supergirl I got. I got Supergirl number 17. This is from volume 2. Slowly picking at this. Got that. I got this. Superman and Batman, Heroes Against Hunger. It's a Neil Adams cover. A whole bunch of artists and writers did this. I think they split this whole comic. Like every 4 pages was like a different creative team. Looks pretty cool. I got 2 issues of The Legion of Superheroes, the Mark Waid and Barry Kitson run. I have issue 1 and 13, so I am almost complete with that, and also almost complete with the Supergirl and The Legion of Superheroes run that Waid kind of started after issue 15. I think after issue 15 or 16, I think. Got those. Got a couple of Adam Hughes Wonder Woman's. There were a lot there, but it kind of stuck to the 6 that I really enjoyed. So, because I was kind of looking for other stuff. This was kind of early in the comic show. So I got 197 with the Flash. I got 189. Pretty cool white cover there. I got 172. Glare's killing it right now, but really love this Superman Wonder Woman cover. I got 170, another Superman and Superman Wonder Woman cover here. Picked up a lot of the covers with multiple characters on it, especially with the Trinity and stuff like that. This one's just awesome. I love it. 159. Love Adam Hughes Wonder Woman's. And my favorite, Wonder Woman 140. Love the Trinity pose there. So, got those. Next, I picked up, I was kind of looking for the Phil Noto cover that he did on Batman. And I found it. And they had the 6 for $5, $6 for $5 for the Batman. So I found Batman 605, which is the Phil Noto cover. Pretty sweet. And while I was digging, I found some Jock covers. So I got issue 650, 649. I love this. I love the green on the Batman. Looks so awesome. With Joker, and I think that's Red Hood. Got 644. Love that. Really like this 643. That pink cover, with the Joker saying, "Hey, you're upside down." That's awesome. And 642. And yep. So those are all my Jock covers. Something to look forward to in the future. Maybe I'll see how many issues he did of Batman Doing the covers, so got that. Next, we're gonna just kind of dive into some rando issues. I got in the 50 Cent bin, Young Avengers presents Hawkeye. This is the first appearance of Kate Bishop, and I also found this, Young Avengers presents the Patriot. So it's issue 1 of 6. I got the Uncanny Avengers 256 Psylocke issue. That was in 50 Cent bin, and I got this for $9. And I've never seen, you know, this issue before. I've seen Amazing Spider-Man 129, but I haven't seen the reprint, which I kind of wanted to get since I'm never going to afford that book. So I found this, got this for about $7. This reprints ASM 129, so glad to finally read it. So I got that. So next up, we're going to go into Action Comics. This is kind of the big bulk of my comic expedition, what I was really searching for, and yeah, so let's jump right in. I got big stack of Action Comics, and I'm really, really pleased on how much I got. So I got, we'll start with these old ones here. Okay, so I got 494. I got 501. 503. 508. 513. This is kind of a beat up copy. I'm probably going to look for an upgrade for this one. And 591, which I have another copy of, but find it for $1. I couldn't pass up that, so got that. Next, we're gonna dive into a little bit more here. I've basically almost finished. I'm like maybe 10 issues, 11, in that range, almost single digits away from finishing 600 to 900. So, you know, so hopefully I can get that done by summertime. So from July to the end of the year, I can focus on 500s. Because I really want to kill the kind of chunk of 500s in Action Comics. So got 601 with Green Lantern. Or no, not 601, 602. I got 608, another Green Lantern. Love these Action Comics weeklies. They're really awesome. 615 with the Wild Dog. 616 with Blackhawk. 617, 623, and I don't really know these creative teams. I know this creative team, 644, George Perez cover. Love this cover. Awesome. 660, the death of Luther. 666. 677 and 700. So I got that. So we are slowly going through this here. Let's grab this whole stack here. Let's see if we can do this right. So I got 713. This is gonna be heavy. Okay, we got this. Okay, 713. This is 714. 715 with Parasite. Love that. I was just watching Young Justice, and they had an episode that was dealing with Parasite, which was so good. Young Justice is so awesome, guys. You guys need to, if you guys have free time or you're kind of waiting for Daredevil, watch Young Justice. It is very well written, and there's just a lot of character development with that, and it's directed by Jay Olivia, which is the main director for most of the animated movies. I think he just recently did the Batman Bad Blood, so that was just, which was awesome movie. Definitely recommend checking it out. So we got 716 little promotion there. 718. But yeah, Young Justice is awesome. 720. The engagement is off. Well, what do you know? Well, damn. 727. I know this was kind of like an homage cover, I think, to something. I remember seeing it in another issue. 730. Superman getting his butt kicked by the Revenge Squad. Is that like the Suicide Squad or something like that? Some knockoff? Oh, here you go. Favorite time of the year. Superman Action Comics 733. Blue Superman. And I don't know who the hell... Oh, guest starring The Ray. Yep. Action Comics 734. 740. Really weird cover there. 742. Blue Superman. Great. 743. Got your boy Slam Bradley back on the cover. 752. 753. The JLA versus Superman. Superman 756. 755. City of the Dead. 767. Part of the crisis, critical condition storyline. Kind of sucks that I can't really read Action Comics straight through. You know, I have kind of to pick and choose my stories and single issue stuff because, you know, the Superman's always famously for crossing over with other books, which is just a pain in the butt. 790. That Crypto? Crypto looks a little mean. I got 799. That cover's pretty weird. I got 807. 810. Pretty cool cover there. 815. 820 with Silver Banshee. 823, 826, 838, 856, part of the John's run, and finally 880. So that is all the Action Comics I got. So I am so glad to pick these up. So I'm ready. I'm ready to tackle. Ready to end the 600 to 900 and ready to move on to 500. 400, 500 is kind of like the main goal coming up next. So we got two more books, and they're Superman. Yeah, so these are pretty beat up copies. Hopefully, the next con I go to, I'll be able to find a upgradable copy for this. But to kind of have the cherry on top, to my, you know, kind of my haul, I got Superman 240, and this is the Neil Adams cover. He just did a homage to it, in the Harley Quinn issue, and when I found this for $5, I had to pick it up. I would have tried to put this in a new bag, but it's a Silver Age bag, so I need to find a bag for this. So, pretty beat up, but I'm kind of glad to have it. Kind of see it for a good price, I'll pick it up. And finally, this is my first Golden Age Superman comic. Paid $20 for it. It is in poo-poo condition, but it is a book that I will cherish. It is Superman 130. I paid $20 for it. And I mean, it is beat up. I took it out and it's kind of falling apart. So I'm probably gonna have an upgradable copy or look for one. But this is the second appearance of Crypto. And also, I didn't know this, I tried to look up more information regarding this. This is actually the first or third appearance of Supergirl. So this was, I think, a month or a week before Action 254, which was, I think, her fourth appearance. So third appearance of Supergirl, second appearance of Crypto. I am so glad to have this. This is a really awesome cover. I could just look at that all day. But yeah. So that is it, guys. That is my haul for the comic show. Thank you guys for watching. It's a pretty long video, but I thank you guys for sticking through. If you watch through the end, kudos to you, man. Pat on the back. Thank you guys for watching. More videos coming soon, and I will see you guys later. Peace out.